Many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nations shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places, and they use for diverse barriers, they say.
Yeah.
All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then they shall deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. So when you see all this, it's me, this is what I think, when you see all this going on, it's meant to be. It's sad. It's extremely sad, but the Bible's telling you this is going to happen.
Yeah, but suppose there's an economy that wants that mentality to continue, and it creates a book where people are cut off from their own power and only go through that book for advice, and then use that to predict the future because that's the way the economy wants it to go.
You know, they have to be brilliant,
though. They are
brilliant. Schools would be to deny an eternal maker of the universe. There's something made. I don't think shit just all happened.
Well, science can explain how things came into being. Physically.
They think they can. And they can. They're not totally convinced of everything. There's no real...
Well, there's a chemistry that takes place, an organic chemistry that takes place in niches, ecological niches, that you can watch life come from nothing. Like, even in a dead thing, you can see larvae. And eventually fly.
And then I just found bacteria.
Life is rock. Life is teeming all the time.
And it's somewhat like Indian philosophy that we all came from the bowels of the earth.
Right, yeah. So there is...
And it came up different levels. See, these are all metaphors. There's all these metaphors for people to grab onto to think about where their existence came from. And you know what? See, whatever the truth is, it's there. Whether we accept it or we don't. And to know what, in search of truth, whenever, each person has to find what's the truth is to them.
It's relative, isn't it? I mean, I have a truth, you have a truth.
Right.
My truth comes from my unique existence, and yours comes from yours.
Right.
Mine comes from how I interpret information and feed it back, and what you can count on about me, because that's what's true for me. And yours is yours. And if I know your truth and you know my truth, then we can relate without hurting each other too much. You know what I mean? Because with goodwill, it's okay to disagree, you know, as long as you can trust each other. You know, but if I don't have a truth and you don't have a truth and we're worried about the truth and nobody knows and it's a political thing and all there is in life is dichotomies, rights and wrongs, lefts and rights, blacks and whites and all that stuff, and you have to get on one side or the other in order to survive and that's all there is, then we're split. We're split inside ourselves. We can't reconcile our own right and wrong, let alone someone else's. And we constantly have to be vigilant about judging ourselves and others to see whether we're close to the good line or not, you know?
You know, everything, though, can't be just one. I mean, there's always going to be dichotomy.
There's dichotomy until you see paradox.
Now, in the sense of paradox being what?
Paradox means a thing can be true and false at the same time. When you have a logical system, that can't happen. The mind who processes information only logically cannot see a thing true and false at the same time. It makes a person, it's called double binds. It makes a person crazy. Now, when a person is lied to...
crazy!
When a person is lied to, a person can go crazy because there's a double bind. Like when a parent says to a child, I love you, but doesn't treat the child lovingly, the child can't reconcile that.
But see, dichotomy, you know, there's always gonna be up, there's always gonna be down, there's always gonna be right, there's always gonna be wrong, there's always gonna be a man, there's always gonna be a woman, there's always gonna be half on both.
In order to have black and white are the two edges of the parameter called color. Without black and white, you can't have color. I mean, color is everything in between, right? So, and black and white are the colorless states. And as far as up and down is concerned, the world is round. There really isn't any up and down. But we perceive up and down because in a logical system, that's what we're comfortable with. gravity and all that stuff, we have a sense of...
There is up, because things will come down.
Things go up and things come down, but that isn't all there is. You know, there's also a state of... Outside the universe, there's no up or down. And there's no... I mean, the Earth is round. It's going around.
Everything's made of molecules that are going around, spinning around, so everything's round.
Right.
Why haven't we figured out the damn equation
and
for
energy,
it?
Energy equals mass times the speed of light. Mc squared.
Mc squared.
So I always say my energy is, the energy equals the mass of my body moving to the tune of the light bulbs going off in my head. Isn't that good? Because you think about, like, ideas.
Right. So,
and the first law of thermodynamics is action creates energy, and the second law is that there's no energy, entropy is used. Right. So it's decay.
There's reactants and
everything.
Yeah.
See, we're used to looking at the black and white of things and having to choose, but if you look at paradox, if you look at things being true and false at the same time, then suddenly you have a berth wide enough and open enough to be able to include differences, things that are not way that you see them, but also other ways as well. Like for some people, like eye contact, for instance.
Right, yeah.
You know, some people perceive.
But see, you know, in cultural things, we can, as a society, learn a lot about other cultures and we can respect the differences and everything, but the state of man is to war. It's in the Bible. I mean, it's everywhere.
That's why I don't trust that Bible, too, is because that the war economy and the crime economy is a pendulum that swings like this. When we're in a crime economy,
you just think about it. It is the truth. You know it is the truth because think about it, Deborah.
Do you go and
no? You think about the competitive edge of people. It's innate in us to be better and to do better.
So
we don't. We don't.
Who are you competing with?
We don't need to see TV or anything to say buy this and have a better car than your neighbor. We don't need that.
But
a lot of people are like that. But
that's a projection. I don't think it's true. I think when I look at individuals, do you kill? Do you have the urge to kill?
No, but I wouldn't do it. I mean, not the urge to do it. I would never do it. I would walk before I did it. I would probably kill in self-defense.
Right. Yeah. Well, maybe I would too in self-defense. I mean, when you're like put up against the wall, you know. And to take care of your children.
Hunters. You know, you look at tribes, there's always a chief. These people have no world, I mean, like we have, that's shaping or forming their ideas. They're forming it right out there in the jungle. And they usually will have a chief. In some of their societies, they'll have more of a cultural group where more people are equitable. And it's very interesting because one family will hunt and gather and share what they catch, and then the next person it sucks.
It's like communal.
Yeah, but I mean, there's still...
It's natural.
There's natural things that people want to do more, but, you know, people would hunt, and, you know, we're territorial animals. Like, this is mine, and you'll defend it, and that's kind of where many of these men are at in war.
See, that's the Darwinian...
And we're using up the world's resources. I mean, under this guise that we're going to go in
there.
We're going to go in there and help them, but we're really going in there to exploit their resources.
Of course. You know, that's why that everybody knows that.
Now everybody knows it. That's why we're being hated more.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And biological warfare is being done to us now. Our water is being fucked up. You know, our food's being fucked up. You know, unless you're very careful about what you eat and you eat close to the ground, you're probably getting instant cancer in your microwave. Like, you know?
Even if you can trust the damn microwave safe. I mean,
I don't think it's safe at all. I think
it
causes cancer.
I slammed the door a couple times in the heat of the
car. I really think it's not safe. And I talked to a doctor once about it. And she said, yeah, it's probably true, but it's so convenient, I don't even like to think about it. Read me something that will make me feel good about humanity and about being a human being out of that book. Can you find any of that? See, it promotes Darwinism. And Darwin, you know, Darwin finally put a cap on this Machiavellian attitude where it justifies raping and plundering and war and, you know, some populations being better than other populations and making it a religious thing to boot. You know, it's like, that was fine until the bombing off of Hiroshima, but then after that, I mean, we could just destroy this place and we know it.